Man United have had every sort of performance so far this season under Solskjaer, and he'll be desperate for an upturn in form against Leicester this weekend. So with that in mind, what I want to do in this video is run through what I think is Man United's best starting 11 for Solskjaer based on current injuries and form. And what I want you to do is let me know in the comments whether you think I am right or wrong with the 11 that I choose. Now, before we get into this, if you are new to United People's TV, come on, make sure you subscribe down below, get involved. But let's take a look at this starting 11. I'm going to run through each position one at a time and explain my reasonings behind it. And starting in goal, David De Gea, obviously. Now, De Gea, like most of United's players, hasn't started the season that strongly, especially that goal against Crystal Palace when he really should have kept it out. But like the other players, I'm expecting them to improve as the season goes on. That contract is still looming over De Gea's head, but we need him back on top, because if our defence is leaking opportunities, we need De Gea to keep them out. Now, it's a little bit different with Wan-Bissaka, who has been outstanding at right back. But what Wan-Bissaka needs now to take his game forward is somebody in front of him, a right winger. And you'll see who I choose later on, but that's what's missing from Wan-Bissaka's game at the moment. I think defensively, his positioning is spot on. His tackling is clearly one of the best in the league. He's great at last-ditch defending, but I would like him to be more on the front foot. For that to happen, he needs a partnership on the right flank. That's key for helping him develop at United. Now at left back, we've got Luke Shaw, who's injured. You've got Dalot, who's in China, getting rehabilitation on an injury. So it's Ashley Young, out of a lack of choice at left back. And the fact that United are still starting Ashley Young is a bit unlucky, because you've got Shaw and Dalot both injured at the same time. Young is third choice, that's where he should be. And he'll probably do a job there, but he won't be very good going forward. So down the left flank, whoever's playing left wing, not going to have too much support from Young, who doesn't do overlapping runs, ever. But that's who I would choose as the fullbacks at the moment. And at centre-back, of course, I'm going to put Harry Maguire in against Leicester. It's going to be a massive game for Maguire. I think he's been okay this season. I think what we've seen from him is what we've been missing, that confidence in a defender to have possession from De Gea and actually play out from the back with it. He clearly needs to improve in certain areas, but every single other player does. But this game is huge for him. And on his Old Trafford debut against Chelsea, that was a massive game. He was imperious. So I hope he can be against Leicester as well. And I certainly wouldn't drop Victor Lindelof, despite him making clear mistakes in a couple of games. For that game against Southampton, he was outjumped by Vestergaard. And the game against Crystal Palace, he was outjumped by Schlupp. But Lindelof, I wouldn't drop him for that. Tuanzebe, I want to see him get his opportunities. And he will be starting against Rochdale. He'll be starting against Astana in the Europa League. And if he shines in those games, then Solskjaer has a question that he needs to answer as to whether bringing in Tuanzebe and dropping Lindelof is the right move. But right now, I'm keeping Maguire and Lindelof. So that's my back five, with De Gea, with Young and Wan-Bissaka as fullbacks, and Maguire and Lindelof keeping that partnership there. But who is in midfield? Now, I'm keeping Scott McTominay in this team, and I want to take a quick look at his stats over on the One Football app. One Football are sponsoring this video. If you take a look at McTominay's stats, it's clear what sort of midfielder he is. He's a perfect partner for somebody like Pogba in midfield, because he's not too aggressive going forward. He has 60 passes every 90 minutes. Attacking-wise, he's not really offering much going forward, but that's not McTominay's game. His game is to keep the ball moving in possession. I think he's very good at that, and to defend. And I think his defending can improve in terms of his tackle success rate, but McTominay should absolutely be starting in midfield. And if you want to see any sort of stats like this, make sure you go over and download the One Football app. There is a link in the description. Go over there. It's free. You get lots of stats like this, and you get match reports and news as well. It is a fantastic app, but I would certainly start McTominay in midfield. But who would I partner him with? I mean, it's abundantly obvious that Paul Pogba is in any starting 11, even if he's not 100% fit. He pulled out of international duty with France over the international break with a niggle, but I think Pogba will come straight back into this team, and he's absolutely in United's best 11 when available. Pogba hasn't been at his best, to be fair, at the start of this season, but only a few United players really have been. But Pogba is capable of turning. I don't know what is needed for that switch to be flicked and for Pogba to find his best form. But United need that at some point this season for us to really challenge for that top four, or we're going to be chasing top six all year long. That's how important I think Pogba's form is to the upturn in United's season. But I would start him alongside Scott McTominay in a midfield too. Now, the number 10 role is a big problem for United this year, I think. Jesse Lingard's been playing there a couple of times. Wan Mata's played there a couple of times. Who would you start there? For me, it's the position where it's most obvious that we didn't sign a player in the summer, because Bruno Fernandes would change that. But out of our current squad, I would put Wan Mata there. Jesse Lingard just doesn't offer enough going forward in attack to warrant a starting place. It's as simple as that. Wan Mata might be slow on the ball. He's got his downfalls as well. But he can turn in possession. He can bring the attack together. And I think that's why Mata gets in my team ahead of Lingard. Who would you play there? Is there somebody else I'm not considering? Maybe you play Paul Pogba further up and bring Fred into midfield, who seems to have disappeared. That's an option. But let me know what you think about that. But for me, Mata is in at number 10. And just as Solskjaer has questions to ask about that number 10 role, the whole front three of United is not certain now, I don't think. But this is who I would start there. And let me know what you think about this in the comments. At right wing, I'm going for Mason Greenwood. I think I've seen enough from Greenwood now to warrant a starting place, because nobody else has offered any sort of threat from the right wing in comparison to Greenwood. Anytime he's come off the bench, he's offered something that other players simply don't offer. Will Greenwood shine in that role? We'll find out. Nobody expected Dan James to shine as well as he is. But as I said earlier, Wan-Bissaka needs a partner on the right wing. And I think Greenwood is the most likely candidate to actually offer a right wing threat. Anybody else be playing that position is just going to drift inside. But Greenwood can dribble with the ball at his feet, run at defenders, can shoot off his left and his right foot. He's fit for that role better than anybody else in this squad at the moment. So I would start Greenwood on the right wing. And on the left wing, there's more questions to ask, because Dan James has been in sensational form, but Martial, he was great before he got injured there as well. Who do you start? Dan James is absolutely starting in this team on that left wing. He's been nothing short of sensational at the start of his United career. He continued it in the international break with Wales with a wonderful curled effort right into the corner. And Dan James has just shown, he's set the benchmark for what United's players and attackers need to be getting towards, if only for the work ethic. He's been really fantastic. I can't fault Dan James for how he started his United career. And I think the likes of Martial and Rashford need to look towards him as an example of what they should be aiming towards, which is not what I expected to say at the start of the season. But Dan James on form, absolutely in this team. And looking at form, that's where more question marks come over the number nine position. Marcus Rashford has been the player who Solskjaer has turned to for the majority of this season. And he was great in that first game against Chelsea. But after the penalty troubles and the penalty miss, I'm putting Martial in the number nine role. And that's because I think on form, Rashford should be dropped to the bench for the time being. It's not kicking him out of the team, but Solskjaer sold Lukaku. He let Sanchez go. He reduced himself to a very limited number of attackers, so he has to try his options. He can't just stick with Rashford all season long simply because it's Rashford. He's got to try Martial in that position. He's got to try maybe Greenwood in that position in Europa League games. He's got to see what works. And what isn't working right now is Rashford as the number nine. So if Martial is 100% fit, and I hope he is, he's had the international break to recover, I would put Martial in that number nine role. And I'd have a front three against Leicester of James, Martial and Greenwood on the right. On paper, for me, I would say this is the strongest 11 available to Solskjaer at the moment on form and with the current injuries we've got. If Shaw was available, I'd put him in there. But let me know what you think about this. For me, Greenwood and Wan-Bissaka, that's what I want to see at some point this season. I feel it's going to offer the most threat going forward on the right wing, and we need that threat because Dan James is offering a massive amount of threat from the left. But it makes United predictable if you've only got one wing to be threatening from. And we need someone like Martial to come in and sort of share the burden with Rashford, because he's struggling with the pressures at the moment, and it's down to Solskjaer to man-manage. And I think taking Rashford out of the limelight for the moment and putting Martial back in would be a smart move. But who would you start against Leicester, and what do you think is United's best 11 available to Solskjaer at the moment, not just for this Leicester game, but just in general. Let me know what you think about that. Get your teams in the comments below. And if you are new to United People's TV, make sure you subscribe as well. Until next time though, take it easy.